According to the city mayor, Edison Asaba Ruyonga, greening and beautification of Fort Poto Tourism City was intended to make it more attractive to the visitors and tourists.
But the cleaning and the planting and the greening of Fort Poto does not entail only working on road verges. It entails working on the whole land mass planning.
The city leadership also had plans of improving the landscaping and planting of fruit trees along the streets.
We are not talking of planting of this eucalyptus syringina, which destroys more than being an antidote to the climate changes and so forth and so on. We are talking about our traditional trees. We are talking about if we planted, say, for instance, fruited trees, tropical fruits, our idea was to rejuvenate, to bring about a renaissance in what Fort Poto used to be.
Ruyonga says poor funding has stalled this project.
The timing itself may be good, but the scale at which we are working is mighty, mighty, mighty sluggish. We may take 5 years without even not working on the road verges.
Richard Muhumuza, the Fort Poto Central Division Mayor, says that the re-establishment of some green belts is ongoing in the central business area of the city.
Greening Walia Road and the roundabouts and some areas in town. But last week, on Friday, we planted some trees. We have planted some trees around town. And our Central Division, we are going to add more trees in our town.
Albert Ahebwa, the Fort Poto City Speaker, says that a number of green belts in the city were destroyed to pave way for the construction of the Fort Poto Kasese Highway.
We shall plant a lot of trees. We shall widen Impanga River so that it gets a bigger water carriage, since it is the only river that goes through our city, which makes it so beautiful. And of course, with its tributaries that feed it.
Currently, Ahewa says that several partners have already come on board to support efforts of greening the city.
We managed to secure some funding from the French Development Agency that will be funding 4 cities that were chosen. That is Soroti, Mbarara, Fort Poto and Arua.
In a bid to make Fort Poto Tourism City a top destination hub, the Deputy Resident City Commissioner, Fort Poto City North Division, Alan Bahuma, launched a 20,000 indigenous tree planting exercise across the city in October last year. Story compiled by Roger Sunday for the news.